Hi, good morning everyone. Right now the time is 12:19 a.m. on the 25th of February 2020, and what a day Monday has been. Basically, came in and has been busy the whole day looking at the market, and the market today, actually not today, today as in Monday, the Monday candle, because now it's still Monday in US, Monday candle formed the entire month of February. So for those of you who do not know, this is what is S&P doing right now. Remember on last Friday, I was mentioning we break the Thursday low, we're going lower. Well, we had a small rebound from almost close to this 20-day moving average, which was the market update, but we gapped down and sold down. Why? Well, basically, over the weekend, we may have a pandemic. COVID-19 basically will become COVID-20, 21, 22, who knows? But then over the news on Italy came out like Thursday, Friday, and there was opportunity. And from there, this is Italy. I mean, you can take a look. Look at Italy chart. Italy today. Yoo-hoo. Look at that. We basically now hitting support at Italy. And a very good signal as of right now at Italy hourly candle. As of right now. Disclaimer applies. Do remember, if you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. Whatever I shared is still my personal opinion. Okay, so this is what happened to Italy, because over the weekend they discovered that not only Italy but Iran, basically we had it controlled in Southeast Asia. China, number of cases getting lower, infection getting lower, but now it spreads to entire Europe. The only country right now that is still don't care but can't right now is US. Because now everyone, most of the country around the world, except I think South America don't have. Indonesia, still zero. So basically now the world is getting it, and it's a matter of time before US gets it. Okay? So now the problem is, basically quarantine flights, no. We basically, a lot of country block the flights out from China. So guess what? Try blocking from all over the world, because now, basically, if you are traveling, a lot of people are no longer traveling. If you go to shopping, well, you hardly can see much crowd, even on the road, much less shopping center. Now everyone goes online, and what else better to do that you can trade online right now? Am I right? Okay, so now let's take a look at the market. Basically, this is today's candle. Today's candle now affects the monthly candle. So I'm going to change my chart in a short while. But first of all, let's take a look to this market. Dow dropped 900 points, but we rebounded, and right now it is about minus 800 points. We had a slight rebound after the Dow Jones opened at about 10:30 Malaysia Singapore time. Okay, I'm going to show you the chart in a short while. But after that, we just tried to go higher, but the selling pressure, the fear was still quite strong, which causes gold to go higher. So let's take a look at VIX, the fear. VIX, let's refresh. Do you see what I see? Do you see what I see? As of right now at 12:23, do take note that this chart may change throughout the day, but this chart will be formed at 5 a.m. later, Malaysia, Singapore time. So watching this very, very closely. Will there be a bearish candle for this to go lower? We'll see later at 5 o'clock or maybe tomorrow morning. So watch this very, very closely in VIX. Okay. And let's take a look at the 24-hour VIX. Nothing. Because this is 24-hour VIX. This covers the Asia and European. This only covers the US VIX. So that's why that's the difference. Okay, so promotional. If you'd like to find out more, do remember to join Gathering of Traders, where I post my market updates. And if you are still interested, got a typo. It is not this weekend I'm traveling. It's next weekend I'm traveling. So if you want this next weekend, I'm flying to Miri. After that, I'll be doing Singapore and Kuala Lumpur. So if you'd like to find out the program in Singapore, drop me an email right here. Click continue reading, find out the program in Miri and Kuala Lumpur, drop an email to liveacademy111@gmail.com. Okay? And if you are not in Telegram where you get the real-time trade alert, this is where it is. I think sometime this week, I will be releasing one strategy out to gathering of traders for you to try. Okay? We have been using it, like it very much, so I may just release it to all of you. Okay? And if you're watching this from the Facebook and you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, do remember to click the like in this YouTube. Do remember to subscribe and do remember to share these videos with all your trading friends. I really appreciate it. And this is also click on the bell so that when there's any new YouTube comes out, you get notified first. Okay? Because yes, I'm planning to come up with a series of YouTube training modules. It's just a matter of time finding a time to sit down and get it recorded, but it is one of my project coming soon. Okay, so do remember to click the like, share, and do remember to subscribe. All right, so okay, now let's take a look at the market. Fantastic, was a good market today. So first of all, don't forget this. Okay, don't forget the VIX. Actually, you had a clue, okay, on Thursday and Friday, because if you look at MAGA, Microsoft, MSFT, Microsoft, see that? Already breaking down on Friday. Granted, it is going higher. Now you know why VIX is a good sign right now. Even though S&P right now doesn't look much. S&P right now doesn't look much. But if you take a look at SPY, apologies, jumping around, see? Trying. But we will know this candle by 5 a.m. Malaysia, Singapore time. So you might as well take a look at tomorrow morning. Okay? MAGA, AAPL, Microsoft, Apple. See that? The clue came on Friday when it broke the support. Alphabet. Ever wonder why Google changed the name to Alphabet? Because, very simple. Remember, what is it? Siri, Google, and what's Amazon thing? Never mind. Because if right now, when you watch this video loud at home, when I say Google, the Google Home will be prompted. So that's why they changed the name to Alphabet. But the code is still G-O-O-G-L. Yeah, the code is still G-O-O-G-L. See that? Nice! Trying to fight to regain this 50-day moving average support. M-A-G, Amazon. A-M-Z-N. What's Amazon really? I forgot. See? But Amazon's still weak. Still weak. Okay? Amazon, A-M-A-Z-O-N, home. Is it? What's the Amazon home thing? Oh, never mind. Okay. All right. So, but the thing is, today's candle basically changed the entire February. S&P, look at this entire February, and this changed the entire February. So, if I change this to a monthly candle, you will suddenly see a lot of nice signals. Okay. And take note, February is only 3 more trading days. Could we rebound 3 days that change the entire February? It is still possible. It is still possible. But if you take a look at Dow Jones monthly candle, monthly, take note, usually people don't trade monthly, but it's a sign of where the next few months the market can go. Okay? Dow Jones, S&P, okay, S&P, Nasdaq, European. Okay, although look at this, you basically can't trade with this. Okay, ignore all those arrows. Those arrows are part of my indicator. Those arrows are what you will get in the New Night Trader Bootcamp. Singapore next Wednesday, closing because I'm flying on Friday. So I need to get things settled by Thursday because once I fly back, fly to Miri, come back at Singapore. So I need to close the registration. France, monthly candle. Look at how beautiful. London, okay? London. Jax, look at Dax. And if you see, shoulder, head, and a possible shoulder. If it's not possible shoulder, because it's very close, it could be a double top. Look at Hang Seng. Not that bearish, because but already came down. Okay, already can't fault because it's so close to China. Look at Nikkei. Look at last week already tells you. Okay, last week already tells you. Oh, hourly candle. Okay, we'll take a quick look at this in a short while. Okay. Because I'm longing Canada. No, that's Swiss. Oh, never mind. What else? Oh, Australia. Monthly. But don't need monthly. Look at weekly. Nah. Your clue could be this morning just to short a gap down and collapse down. This morning. This is today. This is not today. This is not this week. I mean, this week is today. Okay? Say, this is today. You got opportunity. Question is, were you watching this now? Monthly. Whew. China, strong. China, still strong. But could it be that this could be a triple top? Possible. Okay, but daily candle, you had a clue right there. That clue was right there. Okay. And yep, that's about it. And because of the market fear, gold spiked higher. And right now, if you take a look at gold, here, the price here, this was August 2011. That's the high. Okay, and after that entire August, we went up. And after that, when we came down, right about here, I think somewhere about here, 2012, yeah, 2012. That's where Geneva collapsed. This was all the Geneva gold. That is, if you're not from Southeast Asia, you may not know, but it is a Ponzi on gold. And if you take a look at Facebook right now, there's a lot of gold investment scheme. Are some of them Ponzi? Are some of them legit? Are some of them linked to crypto coins? Please do your own due diligence, but gold seminars are back in the trend right now. Okay, let's just put it this way. Some of you were saying, is Jonathan a Forex trader? No, I'm not a Forex trader. Is Jonathan a futures trader? No, I'm not a futures trader. Is Jonathan a stock trader? No, I'm not a stock trader. Is Jonathan a gold trader? No, I'm not a gold trader. I am a chart trader. That means whichever market that has a chart, including Bitcoin has a chart, I take a look. If there's opportunity, I trade. So yes, there are certain peculiarity in different type of market, but the chart, the price is the truth. So basically, I trade anything that move. That's me. Okay. Now, for beginner, I don't expect you to trade everything. So you need to find a few niche market that you can understand. Then you can expand your trading horizon. Okay. So now let's take a look at the market. Individually market, this is all the 15 minute chart. And right now, as of right now, we are at that support and testing that support. Too many chart open. Hello. Ta-da. Okay. So if you notice, apologize if it's a little bit blur, so I'm going to maximize for you. That's the 10:30 Malaysia Singapore time opening. And then after that, we sort of hovering right there. The movement were all in the Asia market and the European market, and the US market kind of full ready, like, wow, we move so much. What should we do? So right now, the US market seems to be, and right now the US, European market are closing already. Okay. That's about time to close. So basically, That's it. Okay? So that's why I took the opportunity to get it record right now. So if you notice, look at that. After the movement in European market, we are on a just a sideways movement. Okay? Might as well go normal because I'll be opening a few charts. Okay? Since I just vested just now, never look at the chart. Let's see what happened. Yeah. Just nice. That's my vested entry right here. Nice profit. Oh well. Apologies. Quick one. Since I'm doing a quick recording and I need some cash for my supper. Should I? Oh well, I'll leave it there since I got a trailing stop anyway. Okay, I'll leave it there. Okay? So still nice in profit, so I'll leave it there. Nice signal just now. Okay, so let's take a look at dollar Swiss. This was what was being alerted just now. Let's take a quick look. That's Aussie Swiss. Dollar Swiss. How come I have this? Okay. Dollar Swiss. Hourly. Not doing well. Didn't enter because I was doing recording. But stop loss is just below here. Still alive. Still alive. Okay. Pound Yen, 30 minute. That was the other alert. We'll do a quick look. 30 minute. Don't like it. Okay. Turn on Bollinger and you understand why I don't like this candle. Alright. So, but jumping around. Today was a long, long day. Very long day. That's go. Okay. Just to take a look at the US time frame. What's gold doing at the US time frame? There. Gap up, sell down. That's the US time frame. And this is the 24 hour. And gold, let's see whether can it form a nice bearish candle. The hours are still young. We got 5 hours to go. 4.5 hours to go. So let's see whether can we form a bearish candle in gold, because I'm watching that. If we can form a bearish candle right here and we can break down this gap, this could be what I call a exhaustion gap. So watching to see. Yes, normally exhaustion gap is 3 gap up. The third gap. We had 1 gap, 2 gap. This could be the third gap. So watching this very, very closely in the US market, of course. So don't see the gap here because it's 24 hours. So watching to see if that's an exhaustion gap. And that will be a nice one for the price to go down before looking out where to enter. So possible where? Let's find out. Short term Fibonacci. If and only if we come down. Look at all these levels are quite nice. 50 and 61, of course, will be nicer. Right about this support. Look at this. And nah, that one not nice. Maybe weekly, can see? Weekly, 50. Yeah, that about there. There. See how nice is the 50? Whew, nice. Okay. So 1567 and also at about 1540, nice price for a gold retracement. Okay, now of course the most important thing is if S&P continues to go lower, if and only if, what can the market do? Well, let's do the analysis live together with you. That's a long term. Delete. Okay. Need to draw exactly at the shadow. Okay. So that's a big term from the 2018. Of course, we are not going to talk about this. We are not going to talk about the 2008. So we just take this one. Okay. And let's find to see whether do we have something that are closer. Look good. And let's see whether do we have something that is confluence. Nah. Okay. No go. Let's pick these two then. Kind of like these two. All right. So now if you take a look, what does this mean? This means look at the FIBO 38, which is right here. Might as well draw it right here. FIBO 38 was the prior resistance. Okay. And if it's nicely go, I doubt, maybe by the time this price hit here, maybe 200, but that will be, they're talking about maybe 2 weeks, maybe, for this line to, for this line to come down and this line to go up. Okay, maybe. Okay, but this is what I'm watching. Okay. This is what I'm watching. I'm watching to see whether can we rebound off from about here. Because it's a, you see, this is a support. Okay, this is support. This is the previous high support. Okay. I'm watching to see whether because of this support, price can go up and then come down. Maybe by the time this happens, maybe. And then there will be a shoulder, head, and a shoulder. So watching to see whether could there be a bullish candle. Not today. Sometime this week or maybe tomorrow. Reverse to go higher and see whether got opportunity to long here, opportunity to short here, forming a lower high, break this support, tested twice, usually support gets weak, break down here, nice profit taking on a short here, and also here, because this is the 200, okay, that 200, of course, the best place for a market to rebound will be right here. 3014. Look at this. Double resistance. Turn future support. So this will be the level I will be watching out for. And that will be a nice time. Remember the motto, buy low, sell high. Sell high, buy low. Nice place. So which is why similarly in gold, I mean, I receive a lot of message. I like to buy gold. In fact, got one actually came over as want to buy gold. Physical. I don't know. I just don't think so. It's worth buying gold right now. Can it go higher and go all the way sky high? Well, possible. But I guess right now, there's one commodity more precious than gold. Is this the mask? Okay? Not the Ace Jim Carrey mask, but everyone wants a mask right now. It's a cheap thing that becomes very expensive. All right. So do take note that right now the market is having the fear. Will it affect the market? Is it good news? Is it bad news? Well, let's just put it this way. We let the market decide and we trade what the chart tells us. And right now, we're going to see whether can we have this rebound. If not, I don't think this will rebound today. I mean, this is just too strong. Tomorrow earliest, because there's a potential strong support right here. And this rebound, see whether can we do this. All right. So, Jonathan, right now it's 12:43. Time for me to take a quick rest and y'all be safe. See ya. Bye.